This short video will go over the basics of keyword and subject searching in a library database. We'll start by looking at the advanced search page of the database Academic Search Complete. We have our three search boxes here at the top. Underneath, below Search Options, we can limit our results to articles that are available in full text and that come from scholarly or peer-reviewed journals. In the database, what we want to do is enter one search term per line. To illustrate the difference, we'll try putting in the whole sentence, distance learning in higher education. If we search it as an entire phrase, we'll get just 80 results. It's not a very good results list, and we know there must be more. So if instead we add it as distance learning, one concept in the first line, and higher education, second concept in the second line, and rerun the search, we get over 700 instead of just 80 results. We can look at the subject lines of the results list to see what other terms might be searchable as well. Here we see that distance in higher education is actually a subject term. So we can search that instead, since we know it's something that the database recognizes. If we run it as a keyword phrase, we get 156 results. But we actually have the option, because it's a subject heading, of searching it as a subject term. What's the difference? When we search keywords or phrases, the database is looking for that anywhere in the article. It might be just a passing mention. If we search the subject instead, we'll get a much more focused results list because the articles are going to be about that topic. So if we rerun that search as a subject term, instead of 156, we get 23. And that should be a much more focused list. We can also search broadly by using synonyms to find anything that might cover a concept, regardless of the terminology used to express it. For instance, if we want to look at distance, or online, or web-based, or remote, and higher education, we can run that search, and we'll get over 3,000 results. Again, when you cast a wide net like this, you can look at the subject lines to get ideas for other terminology to search. For instance, we can look for web-based instruction, we can look for internet in education, and any of a number of other subject terms. Keep in mind, too, that you can search other fields as well. You can search for an author if you find someone whose work you really like to find out what else they may have written. You can search the titles of articles. You can search for terms in the abstract. Journal name is also a possibility. You can take some time to explore the different options available to you.